My hairstyle seems a bit skewed.
Hi, I'm Tanega Malinga, and welcome to my outlet where I talk about my feelings, my thoughts, and my opinions. And if you are into that kind of stuff, do consider subscribing. So, as someone who is constantly like aware of how I am growing and evolving as a human being, I have come to this realization. It's actually something that I've always kind of known, but now I'm just kind of fully aware, and that is the fact that I'm sort of kind of a little bit irritable to people. Oh, I'm a bad human being, I know. But as an introverted person, I say that a lot, and I say that a lot because I'm really starting to come to myself. I'm really starting to know myself, and part of knowing myself is really acknowledging the fact that I'm an introvert and living in a world which I think is constantly pushing us to be very outgoing and bubbly and very much so extroverted people. It's kind of hard to be an introvert. And so I have to constantly remind myself that, you know what, you actually are an introvert, and that is fine. You have to just be fine with who you are.
Be fine with who you are.
So part of my introvertedness, and this is just for me personally, I don't know if this is for all introverts, but some of the introverts I've listened to, they have this trait, but maybe I don't know if it's in the same extreme or in the same measure as mine. So for me, I really cannot handle people for a long period of time. I cannot be with, especially hyperactive and just full and energetic people. I cannot. I feel like I can only have people for just like certain amounts of time, and then I just need to go back to my space. Part of being an introvert is the fact that I just really love my space. And that is something that most people have never really understood, especially people close to me. I've always felt like I was forced to be something I'm not, you know, like just come out of your shell, come out and talk to people, come out and just be talkative and all that. And that was never me. And so even though I would try to be that because I felt the need to be that, it just didn't feel natural. It didn't feel right. And I just ended up being miserable because I had a lot of repressed feelings. And I started to even have resentment, you know, towards those who are forcing me to kind of be something that I'm not. And that is something I'm working, you know, I'm working on, because it's not really other people's fault. At the end of the day, I should be able to speak up for myself and stand up for myself and say that, you know what, this is me. I don't want to be with people all the freaking time, and I don't want to talk all the freaking time. I love my space. That is something I should be able to say. But I am only 24 years old, so there's a lot to say about me being young and not really knowing how to stand up for myself. So obviously 16-year-old me was still a bit timid, you know, and just didn't know how to really voice out and speak out and just stand up for herself, you know, a lot of hand gestures anyway. And so always feeling like I had to be that person, it really, really got to me that because I felt the need and was kind of a little bit forced to be someone I'm not, honestly. I mean, the people who would obviously, like maybe my family or friends, who would always try to get me in the spaces where, you know, we're like always talking or hanging out with other people and just being bubbly and whatnot, they didn't have like any bad intentions. They were just trying to make me to sort of like include me, to be part of something, to be part of whatever was happening, to be part of a certain activity. So it was never anything malicious or anything like that. It was from love, I'd like to think. But then in those situations, I'd honestly feel myself like I'm just like, I cannot. And I wouldn't be able to just like break free from those situations and just be like, you know what, I kind of like gonna be on my own now. Because even if I would say like, oh, like maybe I'm leaving, or I just want to be on my own now, there would always be questions like,
oh, why? Like, why are you leaving?
And those questions sort of like also put me in a space where I felt like I had to continue to be something I'm not, because answering those questions was kind of hard. I didn't know what was happening to me. I didn't know why I felt the way I felt. I didn't know why I loved my space so much, why I just wanted to be by myself all the time. And I thought I was just depressed, you know? But I think part of me being depressed was caused by the fact that I was being someone I'm not. It was more so because I was forced to spend time with other people. Ooh, not that other people depress me or anything like that. But like I said, I can only handle certain amounts of time with people, okay? And the thing about this is everybody always takes it personally. When you're an introvert and have this and have specific things that you prefer, it's always taken personally. For example, when I would say I'm leaving, say maybe there was like a family gathering and I'm just like, you know, I'm tapped out. I quickly like get tapped out. And sometimes I just want to leave. And in those situations, it always seemed like people would take it personally, as if it was their fault that I wanted to leave. It was never just about me, you know, which I feel like was kind of selfish of them, because the fact that I want to leave, I'm not saying anybody did anything to me or that I'm not enjoying the space, but honestly, I was not enjoying that space after a certain period, because for me, I was just like, I'm at my maximum. I need me time. I cannot do this anymore. And people would always take it personally, you know, like,
why are you leaving? You know, you should stay.
Where it was really not about them, it was just about me needing my space. My mouth is getting dry. I need people in my life. I need friends in my life. I need a husband in my life. I need my family to understand me, that this is who I am. Sometimes I tap out. Sometimes I reach the maximum time that I can spend with people, and I just need to be by myself. That is how I regroup. That is how I refresh. That is how I re-energize. I just need that space, you know. And right now I'm even like trying to get, like, even if it's just like 5-10 minutes away from someone, if I feel like it's getting a lot for me, I just need that breather to just not, because when I reach that maximum, it seems like I get moody. And I remember growing up, I was considered the child who was a bit moody. But the thing is, it was because I was like at capacity with being with people. And obviously when I reach that point, I do get irritable and I do get a bit moody. I'd really like to think of myself as someone who's not moody. But when I spend a longer period of time with someone and I'm just no longer there, and I just no longer have the energy to talk with someone or participate in that energy or be with like a group of people, I honestly, my mood changes. So I guess it would be right to call it moody, which is why I just need my time. I need my time to myself. I need to get away from people sometimes. Hence, I'm trying the 5-10 minutes. If I feel like it's getting a lot, I'm just like, I'm just gonna step out. I'm just gonna get some fresh air. I'm just gonna like be somewhere for just like a few minutes. It's not something I explain to people, but it's something I just need to tell myself, like, okay, I feel like this is getting a lot. I just need to step out a little bit. I cannot still I cannot fully explain it, you know, like I don't have the right words to explain what really happens to me. But as part of my journey, I'm realizing that part of being a very introverted person means that I sometimes cannot handle people. Sometimes especially people who are so hyper and are just full of energy, they really drown me. And I'm so sorry to say, those kind of people really, they just, if you're someone full of energy and who likes to talk too much, like I quickly tap out, because I'm just like, I feel like you're draining me. I feel like it's taking a lot for me to just be with you. It feels like somehow your energy is being I don't know, taken from me. It's like you're taking my energy because you have so much energy. And so now I feel like my energy is depleting, if that makes any sense. But these are the people that are in my life. You know, I've had friends who are very energetic and very bubbly and very outgoing and very talkative. I have my sister who's an amazing sister, but she talks so much that sometimes I just keep quiet and she doesn't even care. But I love her. So I need to be able to work on myself so that I can maintain that relationship. But also what's important is that other people in my life need to understand me, need to understand that sometimes she just doesn't want to talk. Sometimes she just wants to be alone. It's not because I'm sad. It's not because this, this, and that. There may be cases where I'm sad about something or maybe just going through something that is just pulling me away from other people, pulling me away from certain activities. But most of the time, I actually voluntarily want to be by myself. I don't want to talk all the time. That is just me. I actually love talking to myself more than I love talking to other people, hence this. Sometimes even small talks deplete me. I'm a very, I don't want to say I'm a strange person, but I'm a very different person. Because sometimes small talks, they just really drain me. I love to talk about meaningful things. You know, I'm not trying to say I'm better than anyone. I'm just like all philosophical all the freaking time. But sometimes small talks really deplete me. Like certain conversations, I'm just like easily bored, honestly. But where I am talking about things, I don't know, that have maybe a certain meaning to me or they seem like important to me, I can talk for hours about that. And it needs to be with someone who's also in that kind of level with me, who can really feel, you know, like, I don't know, the kind of atmosphere that we are just floating in, if that makes any sense. Anyway, that's it from me. I just wanted to share that.
Oh, therapy is so good. Why haven't I been doing it all this time?
Anyway, do consider subscribing. There will be more videos from me. Thank you, promise. Bye.